Hey, how's it going? This is Dave2D, and this is the new XPS 15, the 9560. So the previous generation, the 9550, was my daily driver for over a year. I used that thing a lot. So when this new one came in, I was pretty excited to give it a good run. Now looking from the outside, not much has changed from the previous generation. It's still one of the best built Windows laptops. So a lot of devices that use aluminum are pretty to look at, but they're delicate. This laptop is less focused on aesthetics. I mean, it's still nice to look at, but it's also a tank. The exterior surface holds up well, the hinge holds its tension perfectly after a year, and the soft touch carbon fiber finish, when I first looked at this stuff, I thought for sure it would wear down or at least get scuffed over time, but it doesn't at all. The build quality on this thing is awesome. Another thing I really like is the 4K screen. It's probably the best part about this laptop. 15.6 inch IPS touch panel, amazing color gamut, amazing color accuracy, great viewing angles, super thin bezels, and it's got good software to switch between the color spaces. I consider this to be the best screen on the market for what I do. Now, if you're a professional gamer and you need crazy fast refresh rates, then maybe not, but if you're a content creator or if you just want an awesome display, this one is really, really good. The webcam still looks up your nose, but if this is the price for an ultra thin bezel, I'll take it any day. It's also easy to open for upgrades, and when you're in there, you can do your standard stuff like adding more RAM or swapping out drives. The stock RAM is faster than last year. It's still DDR4, but now it's running at 2400 megahertz. The stock drive speeds are great, better than last year as well. The battery has been upgraded. It's now a 97 watt hour battery, which is actually near that 99 watt hour legal limit. And if you take this big battery and you combine it with that Kaby Lake chip that's inside here, you get really good battery life. You're comfortably hitting 7.5 hours of battery life with the screen at 250 nits. It's pretty awesome. That's a full day battery. You can bring it to work, leave your charger at home, and then just charge it when you come back home. Now if you want to, you can actually remove this big battery, get some parts on Amazon, and replace it with a 2.5 inch drive and a smaller battery. I'll link this stuff below, but I did it on my older XPS 15 so I could have two storage drives. So other stuff that I like, the keyboard is pretty good, it hasn't changed. I like the layout a lot. Backlighting is white. There's nothing I really dislike about it, and it's pretty easy to get used to, but it's not a keyboard that you'll fall in love with. It's good, it's just not excellent. The trackpad is unchanged, glass surface, performs really well because of the Windows precision drivers, and the button mechanics are nice. Now, if you're coming from a MacBook and you've never used anything other than Apple's trackpads, you're probably not gonna love this one, but seriously, this is as good as it's gonna get for Windows trackpads. It's really good, but Apple's trackpads are better. So those are some things that I really like about the 9560, but there are some things that I didn't like in the previous generation that haven't changed. So first, I know this is really petty, but the color of the device. I wish it came in more colors. It has one of the best looking interiors with that carbon fiber finish, but the exterior is silver and you can only get it in silver. You can get skins, I'll link this one below, but it would be cooler if Dell made a dark gray or a black version of this laptop. The second thing are the speakers. They have good volume, but they don't have the best location. They're underneath the keyboard. Even though they kind of face the user, the audio isn't as clear as I'd like it to be. I wish these were repositioned, maybe up to the top or something. The third thing is a little more important. It's the ports. The port selection is decent. There's a bunch of USB ports, audio jack, HDMI, and an SD card slot. I think it's a better selection than some other pro laptops. I do wish it had more USB type A ports, like when you have a mouse plugged in, there's only one of those ports left and it can be a little bit cramped. The other thing is that the Thunderbolt 3 port only uses two PCIe lanes, not four, so instead of the full 40 gigabit per second pipe, you only get half, 20 gigabits per second. So most users won't be affected by this at all, but because it has two lanes, you can only run a single 4K 60 hertz display from the port, and if you want to run an external GPU, the speeds will be about 10% slower than it should be. The new Kaby Lake CPU gives a bit of a performance bump. The system feels snappier when opening apps and games. Same with Adobe Premiere, stuff is just quicker, partially due to the faster clock and partially due to the new speed shift tech. The GTX 1050 is a nice performance upgrade from the older 960M. It's a faster GPU and now it has 4 gigs of RAM instead of just 2. On benchmarks, we're looking at a 25% increase in graphical performance from the 960M. Render times in Adobe Premiere aren't that much faster, but I'm noticing smoother playback and editing using the GTX 1050. Light and moderately demanding games will be able to comfortably hit 60 frames per second with the GTX 1050. If you want to see more details about gaming performance, I made a pretty comprehensive gaming benchmark video, which I'll link below. It's a quiet laptop on idle, often silent. Fan noise under maximum load still isn't that loud. there's a bit of thermal throttling during benchmarks. So when I'm playing games or if I'm editing video, it doesn't happen. I've never noticed actual in-game throttling, but when I run benchmarks for long enough, we do see clock speed reduction. Thermals on the surface look good, there's nothing uncomfortable to use. The carbon fiber deck really helps with keeping surface temperatures down. All right, with the new 9560 XPS 15, you're still getting amazing build quality from the aluminum and carbon fiber materials. The 4K touchscreen is unchanged from last year, and it's awesome. It's literally my favorite laptop screen right now. The backlit keyboard is easy to get used to and comfortable to type on. The glass trackpad is one of the best in the business. On the inside, the Kaby Lake i7 and the GTX 1050 are a nice upgrade from last year's models. Cooling could be a little bit better. The stock RAM and the SSD have good speeds, but if you want, they're easily replaced, and there's a 97 watt hour battery that'll last you around 7.5 hours. Now the XPS 15 starts at $1,000, but once you add the GTX 1050 and the 4K panel, which I highly recommend, you're looking at $1,600 and up. It's certainly not cheap, but it's a fantastic machine. Is it perfect? No, I mean, there's other machines that are really good in this price point, like the Razer Blade comes to mind. That's equally awesome in its own kind of realm. But if you're looking for a machine that has great build quality, like really, really great build quality, fantastic screen, and you don't need like a super powerful video card, take a look at this one. I think you'll like it. That's the end of this video. Thumbs if you enjoyed it, subs if you loved it. See you guys next time.